Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin. Welcome back to the Neo Nails channel. Today I'm going to show you how to do an autumnal design. Basically going to do some like autumnal flowers, but in, you know, autumn colours, not spring, not summer, because that's long gone. Right, my background colour, I'm going to do this all in gel polish, which I love, obviously, because I use it all the time. This is Urban Graffiti, and it is timeless. I'm going to show you on a tip today. If you were doing this on a natural nail, you would need to put the base coat on. So you want the Urban Graffiti base coat. That'll be linked below. If you're doing it onto a nail extension, so like on the top of an acrylic nail, you won't necessarily need a base coat. So I'm going to do two coats of that colour. I think it's a gorgeous colour time. It's like, it's nude, but it's slightly taupe. So it's like, I think it's got an autumn vibe to it. You'll notice I'm starting at the tip and then I go in at the cuticle area because it's quite a long nail. I prefer to do it that way because I kind of slide down the nail a little bit easier. So we've got two coats of that gorgeous colour. Pop that in the lamp, give that a blast. Can you see how it's like? It's like a nude, but it's a taupe at the same time. It's like it, it's just, I like it. It's a deathly color, I would say. I'm gonna use a little bit of Carambola. And we're gonna use, I don't know what, mimosa. I always wanna say samosa. It's not samosa, it's a mimosa. And then I'm gonna use a little bit of firecracker. It's a cracker. And then what's this color, Adam? 208, 0208.
That one is sour cherry.
Sour cherry, right. So yeah. I'm actually gonna use a 3D brush and go down and off and you'll create that kind of shape. So your 3D brush will instantly give you a petal like shape. Draw that. That's literally just by sort of pressing down and then coming off. So you press down and then lift off. You get that little petal shape. And I'm going to use mimosa, not samosa, mimosa. I'm going to do the same thing in between. I have no idea what this flower is. I am literally making this flower up as I go along because I just want to do a flower, but with an autumn thing going on. Yeah. Gonna cure that. And with the yellow, we're going to come into the center. I'm gonna pop that in, and then with the red, that firecracker, just gonna take a little bit of that and come around this edge, just to add a little bit of shading, but with the red. So we know when we go over the top of yellow with red, we get a nice orange color. And I'm just gonna do some little tiny dots. Right, what I'm going to do now is go into the yellow with my 3D brush and I'm just going to spin the end so it hasn't got much colour on. See? Go into this other colour like that. See? Then we're going to go down, pull through, press it down, pull through, press it down, pull through. You see how you get that two-toned effect?
Well, that looks cool.
pop that in. I'm going to go in the centre with the orange this time. Right, then I'm going to use bottle green and I'm going to push that into my 3D brush. I'm going to spin the end so it doesn't have a lot of green on it. And I'm going to go into the yellow. Like that. Can't really see the green a lot. So I'm going to come down and up and go really skinny towards there. So you get like that leaf kind of shape. Do another one here. And then we're going to do some here. Then what I want this to do is go really matte and I want it to be a little bit cloudy. And I'm going to achieve that by getting the matte top coat and a tiny amount of white. And we're going to use a gel brush. A little bit more white and a little bit more of the matte top coat. And we're going to make this milky colour. Keep mixing so that it's all sort of mixed in. You don't want to see like no streaky parts where it's more pigmented with white or it's more transparent. You want to be able to pull it like that and you get quite an even colour. Let's create that all up into a little pool so I can work from that pool. And we're going to go all the way over the top. Pop that in the lamp. So because it's got the matte top coat on it as well, this is going to cure to a matte finish. And you can use that technique with loads of different designs as well. So it's good to do on if you're creating a rose quartz design and you think it's still a little bit too bright, mix some white with your matte top coat or even your shiny top coat, depending what finish you want, and it'll just cloud things over. That's the kind of look I want today. And then we're going to use white. So we've got Snow White. So you can see that's gone to that matte finish. And then we're going to get the white now. And this is the 002 brush. And we're going to frame some parts of flowers. I'm going to pull through a little bit as well. So because we've done that sort of cloudy top coat, we'll create depth in the design. Some little dots there, let's give that a blast.
Gives it sort of that sort of milk bath look.
Yeah.
Slightly.
Mm-hmm. Now with the leaves, we're gonna add some little trailing little swirls. Can we do the same with the other flower? Thank you. I'm just kind of filling in those spaces with some swirls. Pop that in. Right, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm not gonna top coat anything like that. I want it to have a little bit of dimension. This is why we did the smoky top coat, to create depth as well. I'm just gonna take the sticky layer off the white gel polish, because that'll have a sticky layer. Doesn't need sealing, it will really attach to the matte top coat really well. Because it's not, because it absorbs a lot, it won't actually just flake off. It sits on there lovely. So you've got a little bit of shine on the white.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But then everything else is matte and subtle. It's matte, subtle, autumnal colours. Have a little play, you could create anything with that. There's a lot of different techniques in there as well. You've got the brush technique that creates the petal for you. You've got that sort of double dipping kind of effect as well, and your lovely swirls. And the smoky top coat. What more do you want? Apart from a bit of bling, but I think a bit of bling will take away from all that beautiful design work.
I don't think there's any space to put any bling on that.
I know, not really. So there we are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today will be listed below. So if you've missed anything and you think you want it, then it'll be listed below. See you in the next video. Keep watching. Bye.
Bye-bye.